Well, hello there, Chance. I'm doing a review of Final Fantasy VII, the remake, the demo on PlayStation 4. Heck yes. On my first impressions video, chums, I was playing on easy mode. It wasn't really turn-based, it was sort of like more action-packed. But switch it to classic, and it turns more sort of turn-based. I must say, the full motion video sequence in this were breathtaking. Really, really cool. And when it cut into actual gameplay, it was fairly seamless. It was quite nice. I couldn't believe I was actually playing this. The graphics are phenomenally, vastly improved over the original, but you would kind of expect that, wouldn't you? The tutorial itself was easy enough to follow, although when I was doing my first impressions video, not so much, because I was doing it live, so I had to concentrate on the tutorial and also the text that was coming up on the screen, and to be honest, I didn't do too well. And I think that sort of took away from my enjoyment slightly of what was actually taking place, and also I was skipping some of the cutscenes. And yeah, after I played this on my own, offline, I found it to be such a nice experience. It was actually really cool playing it. And after I actually understood the tutorial and what I was doing. Oh, and if you don't like the music, when you go into options, I thought options was a header. I didn't realize I could click it, so I just kept going back to the main screen. But yeah, there you go. You can adjust the volume. So yeah, the music I found was a little bit overpowering for me, so I turned it down. There's some nice little things to find in this. So there are a few hidden chests that you can dig up during this actual demo. So it felt that you could do a bit of exploration. Really liked the banter in between all the different characters. Each of them has quite a decent personality per se. Cloud used to comes out with some pretty good one-liners that actually made me chuckle or laugh out loud, especially his interactions with Barrett. I did find that there was a few swear words and things in there, which kind of is a bit different from the original. I love the way that you can throw magic at one character while beating the hell out of another. So yeah, you've got an ATB bar that builds up at the bottom, and once that actually builds up a block of energy, you can actually pull off a move by pressing X. So yeah, it's a really good little system. It kind of plays into the turn-based style of yesteryear, and yet I really like the fact that you can turn into an override sort of mode, or some sort of rampage mode. I can't remember what they actually call it, but you can go freaking ballistic and do a lot more damage, but you move a bit slower. Swapping between the characters, so you get to use Barrett in this demo, and he can hit all the creatures or the enemies that are high up, which is quite cool. I mean, Sword has got some Cloud has got some pretty decent attacks that you can do with the sword, where you can jump up in the air and take out airborne enemies. I think I pull one off in a second. There's an airborne enemy, and yeah, there you go. I use my ATB and I pick a move. Huck pow! He's gone, he's toast, he's down. So yeah, you just have to time it a bit better than when you're using Barrett. Barrett has got better range. So each of the characters feel quite unique. There are some puzzle elements in this demo. As you can see, I'm not exactly great at puzzle elements. But yeah, it's quite nice after you actually complete them. You get sort of like, oh, congratulations from one of the other NPCs, and you actually feel like a job well done. It's really immersive and really cool, and the actual enemy types are quite varied. I mean, look at this. This looks like it's out of steampunk. It's like an ED-209 steampunk RoboCop medley, which is pretty mental. And each of the different enemies has their sort of weak spots, has a different way of taking them out. So in this case, I needed to use a little bit of magic, and once it's actually staggered, beat the living freaking bejesus out of it while it's on the floor. So here you go. I'm using fire there. So I throw a little fireball, kaboom, stagger the git. He falls down, slappity slap, kaboom, he's dead. Awesome! Great fun, and it feels quite rewarding when you do that. When you take out a big guy, it's actually quite cool. You can skip all the cutscenes. The first time I played this, I selected 30 minutes. And it said, oh yeah, you're playing it a bit safe. And then I did 20 minutes, and it goes, oh, you're being a bit cocky. So it's nice. Depending on the different choices that you make, you get a different outcome, which I really quite liked. And yes, in this demo, you do get a boss fight. Don't worry, I'm not going to spoil out how you take out this enemy. You can work that out for yourselves. But it involves hitting it with big, freaking sharp objects. There you go. But yeah, you can see that I got knocked back. But it's good fun, and it is a slight challenge. And the first time I did this, I used like 4 potions. On the second time I did it, I used none, because I'm freaking awesome. But yeah, I kind of enjoyed this demo. I wouldn't go into it expecting it to be the Final Fantasy of yesteryear. Okay, so there's no sort of like da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da on every sort of triumphant battle or any sort of cutscene or anything like that. You just go straight on to your next fight, which in some ways is quite good because that did get a bit annoying, didn't it, in the original? But yeah, it hasn't really got that sort of nostalgia feel to it. This feels like its own sort of game. This is something different than what I've ever come across in a Final Fantasy game. And elements of it I really, really enjoyed. Some of it I found a little bit sort of clunky, but I could have just been me because I haven't really got into it properly as yet. Now, I really do want to see the rest of the world because, you know, the fire effects are nice, the water effects are nice. I would like to see what the outside world looks like. I mean, in here it's very sort of grimy and greasy and sort of rusted looking, but I want to see how beautiful this game is. So I need to really reserve my judgment at this stage, chums, but just based on the demo, what I played has got me eager for a little bit more. So I'm going to score this relatively highly, but I'd imagine I'm going to score the full game even more so, but we shall see.
Ha! You hear that? Damn thing showed you how it's done.
Come on.
And if you wish to support my channel, you can do so by heading over to Patreon. There is a tier there for pretty much everyone, including ship models. These 10 lucky jabbies are getting ship models. Thanking you, Patreons. And yeah, here's all my other Patreon backers. Thanking you, Patreons. And new to the channel is YouTube membership. Hurry on over, see if it appeals to you. Thanking you. Okay, drop in a super chat or a donation also helps me towards getting my goal, which is a PlayStation 5 and bringing you next gen. Or head on over to Teespring, grab yourself a gnarly mug or a t-shirt. That'll be sweet. Or just hit a like, subscribe, or hit the notification bell. You can click one of these to stay with the channel a little bit longer. Or just don't skip my adverts. That throws revenue down my avenue.